Sonoma County Sheriff's Office, mandatory evacuation order. Leave your homes.
Sir, you get gotta
your,
go!
Get your
car! Go, 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 go!
In the desperate race to contain California's deadliest wildfire outbreak, there are now 40 confirmed fatalities with 15 large wildfires still burning tonight and 75,000 still under evacuation. Nearly 11,000 firefighters are furiously working those fire lines. You see them there, trying to take advantage of lighter winds and a rise in humidity levels. And while fire officials say they are finally making progress, they warn they're not out of the woods just yet. ABC's Lindsay Janis is on the fire line in Santa Rosa, California.
Flames in every direction, incinerating this house, just two blocks from the nearest fire station in Sonoma County. But it couldn't be saved. The fire moving too fast, burning more buildings this weekend in what is now the deadliest wildfire disaster in California history.
There are soldiers in a war right now, and our enemy is this fire.
Today is critical. Crews getting a break from the wind. It's a chance for firefighters to take the upper hand.
We're gonna die, dude. We gotta get out of here.
The fire is now burning for an eighth day. This video showing Mike Vian and his roommate narrowly escaping those first flames.
My eyes are burning too, dude, but we still got oxygen, so we're not dead yet.
Harrowing moments from the night the firestorms first ripped through Santa Rosa. This police officer desperately trying to get people out. Flames inches from his car. 75,000 people still unable to go home tonight. At least 40 dead, more than 150 more missing, and 15 fires still raging.
This is how firefighters achieve containment. They've just brought a bulldozer down here to get rid of the fire's fuel. Now they're going to put it out with their hoses.
Officials using everything they have, planes, helicopters, and over 11,000 firefighters. So far, 5,700 homes and businesses destroyed.
Thank you.
least 40 people have been killed since the first round of fires roared to life last week. And the devastation and destruction has been just overwhelming. Some evacuees now being told that they could return home, but take a look at what they find when they get there. Claudia Cowan, live in Santa Rosa with us now. Claudia, I mean, many people, as we just saw, there's no home left. They can't find much.
Yeah, that's exactly right. Good morning to you, Eric. That is certainly the case here in the Fountain Grove section of Santa Rosa. Ironically, many of the trees here did survive, but the flames consumed just about everything else. But take a look over here. This house is still standing, but of course, the owner of that property